seen that. Oh my god, it's John. So, did you like it?
This is my house.
There you go, he said fuck you. He's, why is he mad? Why is he mad at it? Really? Is he gonna go to go see Star Wars? There is no spoilers. There is no spoilers at all. It just shows you what the characters are gonna be.
Guess thieves tried to lower the statue with ropes, but something scared them off.
You know what John's pulling right now is, hey, up to the now.
Be careful. What the hell was that? As I've never known him. A different man then. Tidy, and everything's clean, ready for a meal to be served. Caretaker must still set the table. Families are all alike. Every unhappy family is unhappy in its own way. Fire damage. Interesting. does that. Chamber. Iris was supposed to be here. Lovely couple. Gotta be her. Damn it.
You wish to see her? Here she is.
A man should frame his wishes carefully. It forestalls disappointment.
This some sick joke. Why didn't you tell me she was dead right away?
You didn't ask.
And why hasn't anyone buried her?
We can't. As for the caretaker, the one you cut down, while still alive, she ordered him to stay away from her for all time.
Her ghost's restless, angry, attacks intruders. Know why?
Lady Von Everick has endured much hardship. She's unaccustomed to guests and not fond of strange folk.
She can't hear us.
Seems I gotta speak to Iris's ghost.
It's no easy task to contact the mistress. Rage and bitterness fill her.
Got my ways. To make contact with Iris, I gotta bury her body. But that caretaker's macabre little cemetery won't do. Too much blood, too much fear.
She spent much time in the front garden.
Maybe there.
Wait. Take this key. It opens the front door.
Good dog.
She liked to sit here, but this is not a good place for a grave.
Too close to the house.
I'll keep searching. This place seems suitable.
Yes, she loved to paint.
Did Iris von Everick have any last requests? Say how she wanted her remains disposed of?
She feared death. Worried none would see to her burial or say a kind word in parting.
Guess I'll be the one to do that. I didn't know Iris von Everick, so I can't say much about her. Fate had it a stranger now lays her remains in the grave. At times, fate muddles our path, and life turns toilsome, hard to bear. Yet all deserve respite and peace in death. You two, got any last words for your mistress?
We don't partake in human rituals.
Trusting that what you've done is in keeping with your customs.
I can't be sure this brush was yours. But if you liked pretty trinkets, you might not mind this one lying at your side. The remains are interred. Let's summon her. Tormented spirit, I've laid your bones to rest. Forget your wrath, forget your grief. Show yourself. Forgive me for tearing you from your realm. I need to ask you. Should I follow you? All right. What is this place?
The Painted World. The work of Iris von Evereck.
How'd you two get in here?
We exist in both worlds at once.
All right, this is lovely and all, but where's Iris?
You awoke her but for a moment. If you wish to speak to her, you must tear her from her slumber completely.
Sure, but how?
You're a tracker, right? Saw you examining the tracks outside.
Yeah, so?
This is a world built of memories blurred and wilting. Moments our mistress wishes to forget, but cannot.
You need to find them, restore them, summon the fears that torment Iris, and destroy them.
Easy to say. And his wife look frozen mid-motion.
One of her memories.
It is blurred, incomplete. You must restore it.
Tattered decorations for a special occasion. A wedding veil? Probably not right. Probably not right. Wine cup, just like the one Olgierd's holding. Perfect match.
Your health, my dear wife.
And yours, my husband.
In my land, Custom calls that newlyweds be greeted with bread and salt. But we're alone for now.
I need none but you. Oh, if only this moment could last forever.
I shall see what I can do. But come in and see our home.
Gladly, but I know this sounds silly. Yet the house has sat empty for so long, and I'm...
Afraid of spiders? I know. I swept them all up and tossed them in the garden.
My knight, you've seen to everything.
Medallion's humming. A wraith?
No, a nightmare.
A fear crystallized, one you must now face.
Dream of the past, but this one's incomplete too. A lavish feast, trying to impress the guests. Silver thread, pearls, it all must have cost a fortune. Seen this hairbrush. It was in bad shape in the real world. Just a little different than the painting. Castel Ravello. A Toussaint wine. Expensive.
My darling, is everything all right? You seem pale, out of sorts.
Everything's fine, really. But why don't you tell me how you fare? I'm ever so happy to see you. Except, why didn't Grandmama and Grandpapa come?
It's a long, rugged journey. Muddy.
They still refuse to meet me. Is that it? And what's this?
We've brought some of Iris's things. Her favorite brush, her cherished doll. This for you.
Banknotes.
We paid off your debts, bought them out, to avoid bringing shame to the family.
So nice of Mama and Papa to remember me.
Olgierd.
Now you see his true nature? I warned you before the wedding. A ruffian and a boor who keeps the company of bandits. Are you not afraid to live under one roof with that rabble?
What now, you piece of filth?
So let's follow him. Not you again. Don't like this place. It's almost gone. Probably not right. Wash basin. Blood stains on it. Blood stained towel. Didn't wash it all off. Got some on the towel.
What time is it?
It's late. Sleep.
Up all night in your study again, I see. What have you got on your hands?
Nothing. Got a bit dirty, that's it.
Is that blood? Have you hurt yourself?
Ink stains. I was writing letters. I shall go to Oxenfurt soon. Perhaps you'd come with me.
Oh, that's a marvellous idea. A trip would do us both so much good.
Then it's decided. Now, time for bed. I'm exhausted.
I shan't fall asleep now. It's out of the question. Come, I shall finish your portrait.
Another blurred memory. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Still not right. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Maybe on this side. Still not right. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Still not right. Fresh, as if someone just rinsed it. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Still not right. This goes here. Fits, I think. Finally, just like the picture.
Smile a bit wider.
Like this?
You were meant to smile, not bare your teeth. No, still wrong. Smile like you did when Papa agreed we could marry. Please? You're useless. I can tell something's bothering you.
I have a bit of work I should see to.
Again? Olgierd, we agreed not to keep any secrets from one another. We promised.
Forgive me. I don't wish to discuss this.
Olgierd. Olgierd!
Master von Everick's study. Here he immersed himself in the arcane arts.
Pentagrams here to bind summoned beings. Lines aren't all clear, though. Need chalk to fix them, then I can set out the candles. Beeswax candles. Blood pacts. Or on foreign presences. Manor was depressing and gloomy in the winter. Chalk, blood, for some kind of magic, I bet. The Gates of Mystery, Between Worlds, Library of an Occultist.
Black magic. That should do it. Now for the candles. Maybe this? Nope. Botched it, I guess. How about this?
Come back! We must talk!
Go away. I wish to be alone.
Not this time. Come out at once!
Leave me be. I merely want to work in peace.
Thank you.
other spell must I use, damn it? I've tried them all. I wish to end our pact. I summon thee!
Olgir cut the scars on his shoulders that winter. Beer tankard, but there was vodka in it, so this is when he started smoking. So that's how he whiled away the long winter evenings. Her father must have been holding the contract.
Furthermore, it is agreed that Iris shall be accorded the respect she is owed, that you shall heed her counsel and requests, and...
Get to the point, Father. My patience runs thin.
Gladly. On Iris's request, I declare this marriage null and void.
You vowed to remain with me till death do us part.
And I've held to my vow. The Olgird I married is no more.
Breaking a word once given does not come that easy. Believe me, you shall stay here forever.
Enough! You will not command us. You will...
Father! Father! No!
Servant, take this carcass and feed it to the beasts.
Then Von Everick ceased to be human.
Though he still loved his wife.
No, he merely remembered that he should love her.
Let's go upstairs.
spent much time together here, the three of us.
In silence.
We'll take our places, the same as then.
You do the rest.
Single place setting. No others on the table. A ladder. Something's not right. Small bowl. For soup, maybe? A large clay bowl. Think this was yours. There we go. Claw scratches. Perfect match. Do you actually eat from these bowls?
Of course not. I already told you, we're not animals.
But the caretaker would set them out all the same, as ordered.
Another monstrosity. I begged you to stop this. Those two are too many as it is.
The dog and cat keep you company. This one will protect you. Care for the house, no matter what happens.
Before, I wished to know what was going on in that head of yours. I thought perhaps I could help. Now, I care not the slightest what you think or how you feel.
I feel nothing.
Just as I no longer know if I still hate you. Go, Olgierd. I want you out of my sight.
Olgierd von Everick failed to understand we'd never be able to replace him.
His spectre now casts a shadow over Lady Iris's every remembrance. We're almost at our journey's end.
What's there?
Iris von Everick's greatest fear.
My dearest wife. Letters from Olgierd to Iris. Were I only as skilled with words as I am with my blade. Especially now, when an icy void grips my heart. I see how you look at me, and I see you wither. I cannot help you, but I believe I can cease harming you. This letter and this rose are my farewell. May you live in health, and remember but the good times, Olgierd.
not him.
Wait, I want to talk.
Not here. Not in this place. I'm sorry. I mistook you for another.
For Olgierd?
I thought he'd returned. To me.
What are you? A ghost? An illusion?
I am sadness.
I've come for the violet rose Olgierd gave you.
On the day we saw one another for the last time, I dried it and placed it in our chamber, at my bedside. I lay there for days, staring at it, until at last it crumbled into dust, as did I soon after.
So, the rose is gone?
Not from this world. Look. You buried my body, and the flowers bloomed once more. And I was held in a deep, dark sleep. Only now have I awoken, just like my beautiful rose.
When you placed the hairbrush on my grave, I remember brushing my hair while Olgierd watched in silence.
Tell me. How is Olgierd? Healthy? Does he fare well?
Your husband hunts out ever stronger sensations. He tempts fate, because at heart he's unhappy.
At heart he is stone, so nothing has changed. And did Olgierd mention me? What did he say?
Not much, but I didn't ask about you. He just sent me to retrieve the rose.
The rose? The last I have left of him. His last gift.
Give it to me.
It's so fragile. Look, the petal edges have turned crimson, as they were on the day I received it. The one thing missing is the single drop of dew which slid down the leaf when I took the rose in hand. Or was it blood? Because I pricked my finger. I can't remember. You know, I never did read the letter from Olgierd. I didn't have to. And I needn't have kept the flower he left me. I've come to a decision. I shall give you the rose.
Our service thus ends. Thank you, stranger, for freeing us.
Before we go, some advice. Beware of the one called the Man of Glass. Stand in his way, and you'll meet a fate worse than death. Seek salvation in glass that can't be broken.
Glass that can't be broken?
So long.
I'll remember you, Iris von Everek.
That no longer matters. Farewell.
winds howling.
Two pints, and be quick about it.
Oh, please, good sir, a bit of courtesy.
So I look up, and Bob's your uncle. He downs half the barrel in one draught.
Geralt, over here. Oi, waiter looks. Use the look of a man who knows how to drink.
Thanks, some other time.
Hey now, don't make me beg. More treats!
Show off.
Of course I am. Wouldn't you be? Time's a marvelous plaything.
And a great spice to use in gingerbread.
So, you were listening. Indeed, occasionally I find time manipulation irresistible. Controlling it offers so many appetizing opportunities. Like spiking the soup of unsavory individuals with appropriately ghastly things.
So, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I wanted to congratulate you. You acquitted yourself splendidly with Allgeard. In fact, you've almost satisfied your debt.
Was supposed to fulfill his three wishes. Did just that. This is where you remove the brand, because we're even.
Nearly. To fulfill the terms of the contract to the letter, you must do one more thing. Draw Allgeard to the Temple of Ilvani.
We never discussed that.
Oh, but we did. As a man of the world, you should know that every contract contains a catch or two. Small print, which, nevertheless, changes the ultimate meaning of the pact. This applies to oral contracts as well. Recall that I said, and I quote, "I believe, however, that all will end well, and once it does, we three shall meet and thank one another for the voyage we shared." End quote.
Yeah, I remember.
Fulfill your end of the bargain, and I will remove the brand. That was the last time you interrupted me while I was talking to someone.
What the devil? Why is there a fly in my soup? I was waiting. Had an eye out for you. Didn't see you come in. How is it you're here?
I'm a witcher. Superhuman quickness. Just one of my many qualities.
You toss this fly in my soup?
No. Now listen carefully. Tell your Ataman to come to the Temple of Lilvani. It's south of here. Entrance is inside a cave.
What's the commotion?
Lilvani's temple. Got it?
Aye. Got it.
Hold there! Your friend, the medic, she were here. Ask that you look in on her.
Thanks.
No stranger to the bottle, eh?
How could you?
He was there.
Blind drunk he was.
Slap a new rice teach. You're a bigger rat picker than me.
Shani?
Oh, Geralt. Good thing you're here.
What happened? Somebody break in?
This? No. Just getting ready to move.
What? When? Where to?
Not what I wanted to talk to you about. Or at least not only, but... I'm leaving, Geralt. The Eastern Front beckons. I'm Kedwin bound.
Never mentioned you'd be moving. Any intention to, either.
I didn't know I would be. Found out this morning. Two soldiers came to my door, said Redania needs me again.
Couldn't turn them down? Just say no?
Perhaps I could have. But I didn't want to. Treating the ill and wounded, it's my calling. No place I'm needed more than at the front.
Can't you reconsider and stay?
Geralt, what for? The wedding, the time we've spent together, it was nice. But you have your life and I have mine. This doesn't make sense long term. You know that as well as I do.
Well... You take care of yourself.
You too, Geralt.
So, learn anything about Olgierd?
Well, I abandoned the books quickly. Decided that if I was going to learn the truth, I'd need to find someone who knows him.
Find anyone?
Turned out I didn't need to look far. A colleague at the Academy, an assistant to Professor Pramathine Shakeslock, claims Olgierd von Everick met with the professor multiple times. Apparently, Olgierd asked the professor to do some research. Professor got so worked up doing it, he went daffy. Started jealously guarding his notes. Wouldn't even let his assistant look at them.
The professor, where'll I find him?
Here in Oxenfurt. Cloistered inside his house on Academy grounds. Mage hunters guard his door.
Need to talk to this professor.
We'll go together. Redanian guards all over the Academy. Doubt you'll get in alone.
Guards have never stopped me, you know that.
Wound these, and I'll have to patch them up. Besides, we might run into a friend. Get inside free and easy.
So how are things at the Academy these days?
You mean since Radovich shut it down?
I mean, is it well guarded?
Might be all it is. Many of the faculty fled to the far north. The braver ones stayed, but assumed the guises of tailors and laundresses. Why?
Just curious. Scholars seem to have adopted mage tactics. They in the same bind?
To Radovid, there's little difference between the two.
Seems to tolerate you well enough.
Because he needs me. For now.
So the Eastern Front, and then?
Depends where they send me.
Wherever it is, take care of yourself.
Always do. So don't worry.
Halt! By order of King Radovid, no one's allowed inside the Academy.
Not even lecturers?
No one means no one.
See, you've become quite the stickler, Norbert. You were much kinder when I was patching you up. By the way, how's your knee?
Fine. Dandy. As if no arrow ever struck it.
Consider yourself a lucky man. Because if I'd not decided to operate, you'd be a cripple to the end of your days.
Bruno?
Eh?
Maybe we ought to let her in. She's a decent lass. Not like to steal nothing.
All right. But alone, which will draw too much attention. I'd rather not get shite from the captain on his account.
Here's what we'll do. I'll go in, then help you sneak in around the back.
How?
Don't know, but I'll figure something out. Usually aren't nearly as many guards on the riverside.
Agreed.
All right. Let me in.
Majesty King Radovid is a stern ruler.
Geralt! Psst! Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Grab the line!
Where'd you get the rope?
Long story. But we've done well. Professor Shakeslock's house is at the end of this street. Witch hunters guard the door. Doubt I'll be able to sweet-talk them.
Been a huge help already, Shani. Thanks.
It was nothing. Really. You'd have done the same for me. If you wish to see me again before I go, I'll be at home. Packing will take some time yet.
All right. Be seeing you. Giving me no choice.
Watch his moving!
Tight. Need another way in. You leave a window open, maybe.
Thank you.
silver lamin. Don't know the sigil. Hasn't been used in ages, looks like. Shattered mirror. No sign of impact. Probably not an accident. Shattered by a sound, maybe. Someone look in it and scream. Boko's lesser key. Tomes about demons, dusty as they come.
Franco? Is that you? Leave the bedpan in the usual spot. And take the platter. I shan't be eating today.
Professor Shakeslock?
Oh, the blazes! How'd you get in? Get out! I know nothing. Don't wish to know anything. Understand? No, no, no. Out!
Not gonna hurt you.
That demon sent you. I'm sure of it.
What demon?
Feigned ignorance. Please. You know. Gaunter old Dim. Evil incarnate.
He didn't send me, but he is why I'm here. I'm a witcher.
A mutant. Yeah. Could be.
Came here because I need information. Think you might be the only man who has it.
A witcher. Then it follows I needn't fear. I'm hardly a post-conjunction creature.
What did Olgierd von Everick want from you?
I curse the day I first set eyes upon the man. He appeared at my doorstep one day, offering a sack of gold were I only to find out who Gaunter Old Dim is and how to get rid of him. I agreed. Such matters are my speciality. And I needed the coin. I pored over countless tomes, delved into obscure incidents and analysed folk legends. I went so far as to travel to Nilfgaard, the library there, where at last I hit upon the mysterious entity's trail. There are records of encounters dating back thousands of years in many cultures under many names, but always as evil incarnate. In this land, we call him Gaunter Old Dim, at times Master Mirror or the Man of Glass. In deciphering the ancient scrawlings, I went blind. Yet I learned a great deal. For example, that he plays with his victims and thrives on pacts above all else. Seemingly harmless contracts which drive their parties to madness.
Olgierd signed one of these pacts with him.
Brilliant deduction. But have you guessed why? You must know that he came from a wealthy, influential line. He must have, if the family of his betrothed accepted him. Yet did you know his fortune soured? He himself became an outcast, impoverished. Iris's family, a powerful house, could not accept this, would not marry their daughter to a nobody. Olgierd wished to elope. The further away, the better. Yet Iris refused to cut her family ties.
Quite the predicament.
Indeed. Their luck turned yet darker when a wandering witch mentioned a solution. A man who would grant any wish. His name... Master Mirror. The rest follows naturally. Olgierd and Odin. Meeting at a crossroads. A wish. A pact signed in blood. And a price to be paid. Olgierd was to sacrifice one he loved. Odin delights in difficult choices. He knew Olgierd loved two in this world. His betrothed and his brother, Vladimir. Olgierd chose, and soon thereafter married his beloved Iris, his fortune restored.
Why was Olgierd out to get rid of Odim? He'd gotten what he wanted.
Had he? His heart had turned cold as ice. His feelings for his wife, for whom he'd sacrificed his brother, had withered. He'd lost all he'd loved. Had he wanted any of this? No. Odim grants what you wish, not what you want. All who sign a pact learn the difference. Die by it.
All? No way to get rid of him?
Kill him, you mean? Kill evil? No. Yet the annals tell of a man who dissolved his pact by defeating Ogdim at his own game.
Meaning?
Ogdim wields contracts, word traps, duels of wits. Challenge him to such a duel. He'll agree, and can be beaten. But remember, there is only ever one stake. The sole thing he truly desires. Human souls.
Thanks. Helped me a lot.
Good. Very good. Ah, to feel useful after so many years locked up, living in fear. Why, it's pleasance itself.
Boy, Creve. Your eyes. They shine so in the dark. Thought at first it were the lizard coming.
Thing that... Need to... Royal Wyvern. Lucky me.
Strange choice of locale. Guessing there's a reason for it.
Wasn't me who chose it.
I assumed so. But since we're here, I believe you have something for me.
Fulfilled the third wish.
How do I know this to be the rose? Very well might have picked this up at the Oxenfurt Market an hour ago.
Look closely at it. Got it from Iris. It was the last thing that bound her to this world.
What?
Iris was tired of living half alive, half dead. Thinks she just wanted it to end.
Can't blame her. I condemned her to terrible suffering. Iris, what a mess we made of it all. If I'd only known then how it would end.
What's happening? I feel as though... a hot iron's pierced my chest.
Sorry to have kept you waiting. So glad to see everyone's made it. How do you feel, Von Emmerich? A little less troubled? Lighter in the heart?
Odim, what do you want?
What do you mean, what? Your soul.
You forget. The pact states you can take it only once you've fulfilled three wishes, and...
And we stand together on the moon. Well, what do you know?
What? No. We had a pact. The moon is there. There! Not here.
I gave you what you wished for. Here, on the moon, our contract you fulfilled.
Awesome. You cheated.
I never cheat. It is done.
Oh!
Your soul belongs to me.
Ah!
At last. It's over. We must meet again one day. Business with you is pure pleasure.
Gonna remove the brand?
Ah, right away. Done. Now, tell me what reward you've chosen.
I want to be rich.
Rich? Truly? For now. But all right. I gave my word. You asked, you shall receive. That should do the trick.
What now? Off to find another poor fool?
Haven't decided yet. But I do know if I ever have trouble collecting a debt, I shall turn to a witcher.
Now everyone joins us.
There's so much fucking talking in this game. I can't hear it half the time. But I just finished the Hearts of Stone DLC, so Is it bad that, like, when someone said there's gonna be a new Star Wars movie, like, I didn't even flinch? I'm about to blow your mind. I haven't seen a single one. Not a single one. Yeah, you don't know how to respond to that, I know. Just never did. Probably not. I probably won't watch the new one. I mean, I might. So long as shit looks cool, it doesn't matter to me. I've got three requirements for a movie to be good. One set of boobs, some gunfire, and at least one explosion. Now, well, this is a Disney Star Wars movie, so I don't think there's gonna be boobs. You expect me to use my imagination? This is why I don't read books. I thought I had a dimeridium ingot already. These fucking diamond dust. You cunts.
Zap. Jesus. Oh, you fell asleep.
I'm sorry, viewer who just showed up, you missed it by about 5 minutes. I already completed Hearts of Stone. Dude, fucking amazing. I mean, dude, it got even worse, man. There was like some serious Dark Souls shit. This is this foggy ass mansion. You go in behind the house and there's like all this fog. And you're like hollering at some dude. No, this is not the free DLC. Yeah, this one cost money. But I fucking got the expansion pass when I pre-ordered. But yeah, he has no face. He has like a big old huge patch of skin sewn over his face. And he's swinging like this fucking sword shovel. Fucking thing looking like a Grim Reaper with a flesh, no face. And every time he hits you, whatever health he takes from you puts it back into him. And I mean, like, his attack combos are like watching some fucking Dark Souls kind of shit. Oh yeah. And as soon as you got him down to half health, he would like do this shit, and this dark mist would spread out, and then fucking ghosts would rise from the ground, and they'd walk up to him and kneel, and he would kill them and absorb health that way. It was a motherfucker, dude. I had to stop and like look it up. I was like, how do you beat this asshole? And they're like, make sure you use Quinn. because Quinn's like a magic shield or whatever. So whenever he does hit you, it breaks, but he doesn't hurt you, so he doesn't get health from it. Still, that shit is badass. And I got his sword. His fucking health-slurping motherfucking shovel sword. It's called the Caretaker Spade. Yeah, it says 10% of damage dealt returns as vitality. It's pretty fucking dope. Whoa, what? The Royal Air Force? Read Nicholas Vogel's notebook. Okay, so I have a treasure hunt. A level 36 treasure hunt. Fuck, am I supposed to read? Oh, there we go. Read all this shit.
My head hurts because of puzzles. They're not easy at all, dude. Really? How about the cog one?
Oh, I completed it. Well, fuck. The Cursed Church. I remember seeing this fucking thing. I don't go near it. Went to sleep at 9:00 at night. 9 to 2:30. You'd be amazed how great you feel when you only sleep during nighttime hours. Like going to bed at like 8:00 at night and then waking up at like 5 in the morning. I don't know, man. It just, I know that's an old man schedule, but it changes something in you. Like, cause I used to work third shift. So the only time I would, for 4 years, the only time I would sleep would be at the middle of the fucking day. And I was eventually reaching this point where I was always getting sick. I always felt like shit. I never felt energized. And I signed for a job to put me on second shift so I could come home, play video games for a few hours, and mainly do most of my sleeping at night. And I think it took less than a week, dude. I felt fucking reborn. Shit, not sleeping like the normal hours humans are supposed to fucking sleep, it can make you fat, it can make you sick, all kind of shit. Oh, didn't get it fast enough. I hate when these motherfuckers blind you. That's it? Not even a sword? Nothing? Find the sunken ship using your witch's hat. A hula show? Like hula dancers? Or you're watching a show on Hulu. Are there boobs? So, fucking research has finally found something bad to say about fucking e-cigarettes. And it's actually true. It's not a bunch of propaganda bullshit. It weakens one's bones.
What?
Vaping. Some of the flavor concentrates contain something that's acronymed fucking like IBDRM or some shit like that. But over prolonged periods of time, it'll start to weaken your bones.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. But like I said, it's like isolated. They're only finding it in certain juices, primarily fruity flavors. So that'll be something that they get out. It'll stop using it. Because that's pretty much what happens. They keep doing research, and then they find something that are like, oh, okay, so this right here, this deteriorates bone cells. Alright, we're gonna get rid of that. Stop using that shit. But it takes like 50 years, they said. Oh shit, I got comments. Puff Oppo, what level are you? 38. What happened? I could try to give you my Amazon Prime information. We almost never use it. I don't know, man, but Netflix seems to be fucking infinite. I'm gonna do a new game plus here soon. Now that I've got all the DLC gear. Kinda. Come on, you bastard. Whoa. There you go. There's 400 fucking... 400 bucks in that bag. I'll take that. But Puff Oppo, the best thing to do for like good gear and loot is just watch YouTube videos on where Witcher gear is, play the story, loot everything, and craft Witcher gear. Puff, once you go to the Isle of Mist, dude, after that, your level just skyrockets. Like, every conversation you have, your fucking level goes up. You go from level, like, 22 to level 30 in no time. I didn't think that far ahead.
Fuck, I just got ruined.
How long must I follow these damn footprints? Yeah, he did. Like, oi. The Walking Dead. Oh, the Order. There's it. Dude, Raph. Far Cry 4. To me, that's an easy platinum. It just takes time. Probably.
Honestly, all I'm doing in Call of Duty is doing AI battles.
fucking Geralt. Some dude's just like telling this sad story. He goes, I couldn't give a shit. Not the tiniest, slimiest little green shit in the world. Yeah. Somebody's giving him a stop. He's like, well, I really don't give a shit. Not the tiniest, littlest, slimy green shit in the world. Must you block every fucking thing? And then this guy with this fucking bow. There's always one of you fucking ass munches. Can't get away from these fucking pricks. Ham sandwich. That's the first thing I did when I played the freaking demo. I was like, oh, I know what to do with this. Shoot at it. Gotta loot it all. I just fuck up every single time and buy digital.
I'm just too fat and lazy to get out. That's pretty much.
Yeah, that was my thing. I was like, wait. First of all, I have to leave the couch. Second of all, if I want to play something else, I have to get off the couch again. I don't like this business model. This is not going to work. We've got to change this.
Guys, I'm out.
Sweet dreams, Thomas.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to go to bed too. My fucking eyes are burning. Fucking good, dude. At a discount for like all the paid DLC for $60. I don't know, man. When I saw Witcher 3, I was like, oh my god, it's the Skyrim I need. Maybe. It depends. Like, certain games, they're not worth shit right out of the gate. Other games, they hold their value, but not for more than a couple months. After that, like $15 is the best you can hope for. Like in the same week that fucking Tony Hawk Pro Skater 5 came out, and I got it from my wife, she decided she hated it. I took it back like 3 days later, and it was only $25. Yet I was able to return Battlefield 4 3 months after release on Xbox 360, because I had bought a PS4, and I still got $40 for it. Because nobody wanted. Yeah, but like, the thing is they're not going to give you a lot of money for it, because they're not sure if they're going to sell it. Nobody wants that shit. It was a shitty game. IGN's review was, don't waste your money. Because there's not much my wife plays. And I didn't get it for me, I got it for her. Because she was excited for it. She was really excited. And then she's like, I'm sorry, babe. I tried really hard to like this game. I just can't. I wasn't mad. I was like, no, babe, I get it. If you don't like it, tell me now. I'd rather take it back now and get as much money back as I can to put towards something else. So much little crap I didn't do. Oh. Wait, where? Where are we talking about? Well, they're still doing that shit. It's just not news anymore. They're old school over there, man. You get caught stealing some dumb shit, and they're like, your hand. Yeah, well, cut your fucking hand off and nail it to the wall. Wyvern ain't shitting around. Damn. Fuck you in particular. Oh, I'm gonna use that on my boss tomorrow. That's gonna be great. Well, no, like earlier tonight, today, man, we were running some shit. Fucking. it doesn't have any print on it because it's pre-printed. The paper that the corrugator uses has all the print on it. Problem is those motherfuckers couldn't cut every single sheet in the same spot, so I'm trying to run it through my machine, which is doing all the die cutting work, and the print keeps fucking moving, you know, because the blanks, each one fucking is different. She'll move an inch and a half, and that makes it bad when it comes out the other end. So I'm getting mad downtime and shit. And he comes over and he goes, "Hey man, over on the 44, they don't stop. They just run it. And whatever the customer gets is what they get." And I just looked at him and I was like, "Man, I signed a piece of paper that says you fire me for stupid shit like that. You're giving me the go ahead to just send bad boxes." He's like, "Yeah." I was like, "That's a good way to end up in the fucking frying pan, dude. I don't want to end up in your boss's office having to answer yes to one of the two questions. Are you so stupid you didn't see this? Or are you so stupid you thought it would be okay to send this out?" Like, pull your head out of your ass. That's what I told him. I finished it with, "Pull your head out of your ass." He goes, no, you're doing the right thing. I was like, "You're damn right. That's what I do." Oh yeah, I forgot about the Twitch app. Maybe. I don't know, man. I like how YouTube fucking automatically publishes my stream. I don't gotta do shit. All I gotta do is choose a title. And until Twitch gives me that, YouTube, I choose you. Alright guys, I'm going to bed. I'm fucking tired. Later.